In this video, I'll be talking about grammars of TOC, rules for writing the grammar, Chomsky hierarchy, and then we'll be solving some practice questions. In the upcoming videos, I'll be discussing more problems on regular grammar and context-free grammars. Subscribe to this channel, and if you don't want to miss any further updates, click on the bell icon. A grammar consists of four tuples. V, the set of variables. T, the set of terminals. P, production rules. And S denotes the starting symbol. B, the set of variables, is also known as non-terminals. It is usually represented by uppercase alphabets like A, B, C. Okay? Then T is a set of terminals. It can be represented by lowercase alphabets like A, B, C up to Z, or 0, 1, 2, 9, or stars, dollar symbol, etc. P means the production rules. Production rules can be represented like this. Alpha derives beta, where alpha and beta belongs to the union of V and T, variables and terminals. When it is shown like this, alpha derives beta, that means that alpha directly derives beta. But if there is a star beneath this arrow symbol, then this means that alpha derives beta in a number of steps. If I can say that A derives B, then it will be like this, that A directly derives B. But if I say that A derives B and I put a star here, that means that A will derive B in a number of steps, like A derives C and C derives B, then we can say that A derives B in a number of steps, and we put a star under the arrow symbol here. Okay. The starting symbol S can also be defined by any other symbol, but it will be mentioned in the question. Here we have two note points. Two grammars are same if they generate the same language. That means if the language of grammar 1 is equal to the language of grammar 2, then we can say that grammar 1 is equal to grammar 2. For example, if L1 is all even strings and L2 gives all strings divisible by 2, then ultimately the two languages are same only, because all even strings are also divisible by 2. Then we can say that grammar of language 1 is equal to the grammar of language 2. Another note point is, it is a restriction on all the grammars. At least one variable must be present on the left side of the production. See, the left side of the production is alpha. Alpha side, there must be at least one V. Okay? This type of restriction is valid for all the grammar. There are four types of grammar. Type 0 grammar or unrestricted grammar. Type 1 or context sensitive grammar. Type 2 or context free grammar. And type 3 or regular grammar. Type 0 or unrestricted grammar. This type of grammar is recognized by a machine called Turing machine. The language accepted by this type of grammar are also known as recursively enumerable languages. Grammar productions are in this form. Alpha derives beta, where alpha can be both variables and terminals, but according to the restriction, at least one variable must be present in alpha, and beta can be variables and terminals. We can have one type 0 grammar like this. S derives AB. See, there is no any other restriction except that it must be of this form. So this language is of this form, right? So this is a type 0 grammar. Again, another type 0 grammar we can have is SAB derives CD. This is also a type 0 grammar. Okay. Next, let us see type 1 or context sensitive grammar. It is recognized by a machine called linear bound automata. The language accepted by this type of grammar is known as context sensitive language. Grammar production is of this form. It is the same as type 0, that is alpha derives beta. But here we have only one restriction, and that is the number of symbols in alpha must be less than or equal to number of symbols in the beta side. You can say this sentence in this way, that number of symbols in the left hand side of the production must be less than or equal to the number of symbols on the right hand side of the production. Some examples of context sensitive grammar are S derives AB. See, first condition is It must be of the form alpha derives beta. So it is of the form alpha derives beta, right? Next, alpha, length of alpha should be less than equal to length of beta. Length of alpha is 1, as there is only one symbol here, and length of beta is 2. So since 1 less than 2, this satisfies this rule also. So this example is a context sensitive grammar. Also, we can have another example like A derives A. Here, it is of this form, alpha derives beta, and also length of alpha is less than equal to length of beta, because length of alpha is 1 and length of beta is 1. So it is satisfied. This type of production rules are accepted by context sensitive grammar. Next, let us see type 2 or context free grammar. This type of grammar is recognized by a machine called pushdown automata. The language accepted by this type of grammar is known as context-free language. Production rule for this type of grammar should be, first of all, it should be type 1, that is alpha derives beta, and number of symbols in alpha must be less than equal to number of symbols on beta. And also it has one more restriction, and that is the length of alpha should always be equal to 1. Okay, in context free grammar, length of alpha must always be equal to 1. So for example, we can say productions like S goes to AB are productions accepted by the context free grammar, or this type of productions are valid in context free grammar. Also, you can have productions like A to A. See, is this of this form alpha to beta? Yeah, both of them are this form, alpha derives beta. And also length of alpha is less than equal to length of beta, right? Length of alpha is 1, here 2. So length of alpha is less than equal to beta, and length of alpha is equal to beta. Also, length of alpha should always be 1 in context-free grammar, which is satisfied here. So this type of grammars are said to be valid in context-free grammar. Now let us see type 3 or regular grammar. It is recognized by a machine called finite state automaton. The language accepted by this type of grammar is known as regular language. This is the most restricted form of grammar. The production can exist in only two forms. Either it will be left linear or right linear. In left linear, variable is followed by terminals, whereas in right linear, terminals are followed by variables. See here, V denotes variables and T denotes terminal. Then V derives V. For example, S derives SA, right? So this is a left linear grammar. Left linear grammar can also have only terminals, right? So if there is a production such as S derives A or S derives B, then that is also a regular grammar. So we can combine these two and write it as S derives SA or A. Okay, in right linear grammar, the terminals are followed by variables. Example of right linear grammar is S derives AS, right? A is a terminal, S is variable. Your terminal is followed by variables. So this is a right linear. It can be of this form, right? So we can combine these two and write it as S derives AS or A, right? So this is type 3 or regular grammar. Let us see Chomsky hierarchy. Chomsky hierarchy says that every type I language includes all the type I plus 1 language. See, for example, if I is equal to 2, then what is I plus 1? I plus 1 will be 2 plus 1, which is 3. That means all the type I, that means type I means type 2. In our case, type 2 language will include all the type I plus 1 language. What is the type I plus 1 language? Here, for this case, type I plus 1 language is type 3 language. That means that type 2 will be including type 3 language. That means we can write it as, suppose if we denote type 2 by T2, T2 will include, so T2 is a superset of T3 and T3 is a subset of T2. When I is equal to 1, then I plus 1 will be equal to 2. Then all the type 2 languages will be included in all the type 1 language, right? That means all the type I languages, I is 1, so type 1 language will include all the type I plus 1, type 2 language. So type 1 language includes type 2 language, but type 2 language also includes type 3 language, right? Type 2 language includes type 3 language, so we can ultimately say that type 1 language also includes type 3 language, right? Okay. Now again, when I is equal to 0, then I plus 1 is equal to 1, then we can say that all the type I language, that is type 0 language, will include I plus 1 language, that is type 1 language. But type 1 language also includes type 2 and type 3 language, right? So ultimately we can say that type 0 language will also include type 2 language and type 3 language. So as a whole, it is represented by this diagram. See, all the type 0 language will also include type 1, type 2 and type 3 language. Type 1 language will also include type 2 and type 3 language. Type 2 language includes type 3 language. Okay. We can say that all the grammar rules followed by the regular or type 3 grammar will also be followed by the context-free grammar. Right, and all the grammar rules followed by the context-free grammar will also be followed by the context-sensitive grammar, and all the grammar rules followed by the context-sensitive grammar will also be for type 0 or unrestricted grammar. But it is not necessary that type 3 follows all the rules that type 2 follows. But type 2 grammar, that is our context-sensitive context-free grammar, will follow all the rules of regular grammar. It is said that practice leads to perfection. So try to solve the practice questions given at the end of this video. Also hit the subscribe button and then press the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever I upload a new video. And do not forget to share your exam buddy videos with your best buddies. Comment below your doubts and tell me which other topics you want me to discuss next. Thank you so much for watching.